Alrighty everyone, hello, this is Mr. GGKB, and welcome to What If Deku Was Betrayed. Now, the ship for this one, I've got no idea, so if you've got an idea, drop down a ship. It could be someone from MHA, someone from a different universe, a different anime, different one of my other series. Remember, I do have OCs. That are in there. Like my Four Horsemen, three of them are OCs I've made. My Wendigo, that's an OC I've made. And then go up. Yes, this is What If Deku Was Betrayed and Cheated On. I've got the cheated in there, but it's a given at this point. Alright. Basic premise of Uzuka Midoriya in this one. UA is a college, so that's where we'll be starting off. In this one, everyone hates Uzuka. If you're wondering why he's cheated on, you'll see in a bit, they all pretend to like him. You know, it's the worst kind of stab in the back you can get. An old quote goes, "One should not fear a competent enemy, but a foolish ally." Same thing can go for friends, fake friends. So yeah. Just may have had fake friends. One that I chose to be, but thought it was my brother. Basically pretty close, thought it would be my brother, but basically brothers, but betrayed me in the end. That shit hurt. Still hurts. To this fucking day. But anyway, alright, so everyone pretends to like Uzuka, although they're in their heads, it's like the worst kind. Look, if you're gonna be a dick, be a dick just straight to their face. At least that means you've got fucking balls. Being a dick behind their back shows you nothing more than a coward, conniving, sneezing, little shit. And that's what these people are. Now, how the cheater comes into this. Uzuka is dating Uraraka. Yes. And we're not supposed to see that. This was what Uzuka does look like. This is his original character design before it got changed into the green-headed boy we love and know today. But anyway, that would be Mizuguru's current look. It would change all the way down the line. Don't worry. But in this, he is dating Uraraka, but she is fucking two guys behind his back. Tenya Ida and Bakugo Katsuki. They do something called a spit roast and tag team. Yeah. And she doesn't do it for the money. She does it behind Uzuka's back because she hates Uzuka. But she pretends to love him. Even his own mother doesn't like him. And she physically shows that. Like, she right out just fucking threw shit at him. Bottles, plates, knives, forks, spoons, bowls, metal pans, metal pots. The dude's got a lot of cuts and shit. And he thought, anyway, it'd be different, but it's not. Now, not everyone hates him. I can't do Ozawa dirty. I just can't. No, I can't do Midnight or Nezu dirty. Those characters just... No, I don't see it happening. But anyway, onto the story. Uzuka does have All For One, but for the sake of the story, All Might thinks he takes it back, but he doesn't. I'll leave that up to you. If you guys still want him to have One For All with the quirk I'm about to give him, sure. But if not, just let me know in the comment down below. Sorry if you catch me yawning. It is currently 1 a.m. So I procrastinated this for a bit. My bad. Anyway. They're at a karaoke bar. All over the age of 18 or 18. So they're drinking, smoking, you know. Normal college stuff. Having a party because it's nearly the end of the semester. Now, Ziku goes out, walking out in the alleyway. And, well, two people fall. Or should I say three? Everyone notices that he's gone. And Todoroki notices that he's gone out to the alleyway to have a bit of a smoke. Away from everyone. So, he goes back in, nods, says he's outside. And this is when three individuals get a conniving, evil plan. These three people being Bakugo, Ida, and Uraraka. And Zuka's just standing in the alleyway, on his phone, smoking. And this is when they pretend to smile, say, hey, how you doing, all that. Then, tragedy happens. Zuka was stabbed by Uraraka in the back. She's behind him, hugging him from behind. And stab. By this point, All Might has taken back the quirk because he thinks Mario is better. But like I said, I don't think I'll be giving it away. Most likely because of this story. Just give another fuck you to Fuck Might. Fuck Might. Fuck me. Alright, anyway. Shit, I'm sorry everyone. I haven't slept yet. My sleep schedule's fucked. Anyway, she stabs in the back as he falls down, looking up at the sky. He looks at them, going, why? As she gets down on her knees, and sucks the two off. Twin goes behind her, fucks everyone behind, while the other one still fucks her mouth. And Zuko is living long enough to see this. She didn't stab in a vital place, but it's a place where he's paralyzed and can't move. And well, he's helpless. He's asking why. Why, Tenet? Why? Why me? What did I do to deserve all this pain, hatred, and agony? As the two finish inside her, she walks over and spits all the, you know, Milky Way out of her mouth onto Azuka's face. She says, I never loved you, Deku. You're so worthless, can't believe you didn't see that. Everyone in school hated you. Everyone. We all wanted you to die. I guess now we get to see that happen. Isn't that right, babes? As the two snicker, saying, yeah. As Ida takes a running start, activates, you know, super burst, kicking Izuku far down the alleyway, breaking his chest, and making his insides bleed as his Bakugo walks up, exploding his face, leaving a giant scar down it on the right side of his face. Side of handprint. That's right, hit it at point blank range. A handprint over his right side. Completely burned and charred. With that, Uraraka takes out another knife and stabs his heart. As they return to the bar, Izuku is just laying there. Just wondering what he did wrong to deserve all this. All this pain, this hatred. This unfairness in life. His eyes go black, dull, and lifeless. He notices nothing. There's nothing beyond the life, just death. And by this point, a screen pops up. Your heart will stop beating. In 0.01 of a second, if you do not accept this offer. And if you wonder what I'm giving it, yes, solo leveling. He's gonna have the solo leveling system. He'll end up like this, don't worry. But for now, he looks like this. Izuku's contemplating and says, I don't know. As the screen changes, saying, your heart will stop if you do not accept this offer. Do you want revenge on those who betrayed and cheated on you? Izuku gets wicked ideas flooding his mind. Seeing all those people who wronged him suffer. So he agrees. He dark blue and black light appear, and Izuku's body is gone. Though no one in 1A really cares, except for Aizawa, Nezu, and Midnight. A couple months pass, and, well, Izuku is pronounced dead. There's the three who killed him, Snicker. But the others, they feel emptiness. Like, something's missing. Like a light of joy and happiness. Vanished from their lives. And then that's when they realize, since Izuku Midoriya is gone, so is their joy. Now in this, Izuku was always happy, blaming even if he was ridiculed and everything behind his back. But now three don't care. They've all been worthless, not good for anything. As Mina catches this, now none of them knew those two, but those ones were dating, but they knew it was Uraraka and Uraraka and Izuku were dating. So you know, as Mina catches a glimpse of Bakugo and Ida, Uraraka, in an alleyway. In another classroom. Uraraka saying, Harder, please. There's a burst going at it from behind. One in entrance one and the other in entrance two. as she sees this sneaking, just watching. She runs back to the class, everyone there. And she explains what happened, what she saw. The others know that something was up. Not only did she not care, but fucking other two guys? Look, we might have betrayed him and talked about him behind his back. This is inexcusable. But they don't care. Well, actually they do, but they pretend they don't. So Uraraka comes out with this white liquid dripping down her leg. This Momo asks, where did you guys go? No Todoroki member are not dating this, it's neither. No one is dating this besides the people I've already said. As she says, well, since you guys do decide to know, I've been dating these two behind Izuku's back. And oh my goodness, so much better than Izuku. Now that's a lie. Her and Izuku never did it. At all. He was waiting for the right time. He wasn't ready. As they all thinking in their heads, those cunts. Betraying him is one thing, talking about his back and all that, but dating the people he thought as his best friend and his brother? That's sickening. As Todoroki is hiding his emotions with his plain face, contemplating what he's done wrong. Because Izuku helped him with his fire, and he betrayed him, like that. Now let's cut to Izuku. He wakes up. What seems to be in another alleyway. And yes, I'm sending Izuku Midoriya to the solar leveling world. He wakes up in Korea. Now Johnson, you know, some literally main character. If you know his name, because I cannot remember it now, just pop it down in the comments for me. Johnson Woo is, well, not in this story, he's not in it. But Johnson Wu's family is his mother and his sister. And that's it. Now Izuku 18 has finished high school. And this is finished, you know, school and everything. But anyway, I don't know Johnson Wu's mom's name, so I'm just gonna call her. I think it was Jin Wu, I think. I think I could be wrong. Anyway, she sees this boy, with a knife in his back, a skull on his right face, and clinging onto life. Now, the system hasn't kicked in yet. Yes, he said yes, and it's brought him to this world, but it's gonna take a couple of days. So, Jin Woo's mom sees this, picks him up, and takes him to her house. His sister is there. I don't know her name. Can't remember it right now. She comes out and seeing her mother carrying in what it looks to be a 20-year-old boy. Yes, he's 20 in this. Is it over or just turning? So there, it's a good 20. I'm saying to become a hero takes about 5 years. And he joined when he was 18. Anyway. As Gentleman's mum says, I don't know. I just found him in the alleyway. He seems to be bleeding, but it looks like it stopped. The burn on his face, I don't think that can get healed. And that she feels his ribcage. It's healed now, but she could feel some abnormalities. Unless, yes, she is a nurse. Not just a stay-at-home mom. And she lifts up the shirt, seeing cuts, bruises, burns, anything and everything on the body. But Jomisu's sister blushes, seeing how ripped he is, being so damaged. As she catches on to this, and just leaves it for now. But yeah. Anyway, Izuku passed the fuck out. Sleepy. Oh god. How long has this video been going for? 2 hours. Alright. Next day happens. Izuku slowly working up his eyes to see. And cliffhanger. That's right, I'm leaving you on a cliffhanger. Why? Because I fucking can. Now, the only reason I'm leaving you a cliffhanger right now is because I've got other videos I want to make. And I hope you all love this. Hope you have a lovely day, night, depending on time zones. And, yeah. Goodbye, all. Love you, and see you next time.